morning, students. Today we will see about one poem and one prose. The prose, the fringe benefits of failure and the importance of imagination, written by Rowling. Rowling, as you all know, the writer of Harry Potter, how she had suffered in her life in her early days and how now she has become successful is shown in this poem, in this particular prose. She wrote few poems also, but with respect to our portion, we are having only the prose part. What is failure? Failure is what we expect of and what we are not able to achieve it. So failures are the stepping stone to success. Everyone wants success in their life, but success, if we attain it, all of a sudden we will not know the value of it. So we have to first face the failures in our life, then only we will know the importance of success. What we learn from our failures are the important lessons which we should not forget in our life. In this particular prose, this is actually a speech which she addresses a group of students, the passing graduates, when they are attending their convocation. On that day, when she attends there as a chief guest, as a celebrity, she addresses the students, the pass out graduates, and she says to them her personal experience, what were things with her, how she faced them. When she was a student, her parents expected her to study vocational course, but she took classics, that is arts, MA English Literature. She was not interested in the vocational courses. They were also important for us because they are the correct way to get an immediate recruitment or job. But she took on to classics because she was interested in it. She told a lie to her parents for continuously 3 years. It was a guilty feeling for her, but even her friends were very good. They didn't let out the secret to her parents or to anyone. Once she was successful, she completed her degree, she passed out and she came out. She faced the real life. There she married a person who that person left her on the middle of the road with her baby in her womb and said that she is in not need of her anymore. How did she face the situation? She did not cry in that situation. She took the help of one of her good friend who gave her shelter. That lady gave her shelter without telling his husband. She was kept in a storeroom like few days in a garage, and she was given a typewriter. Using the typewriter, she started writing the script for Harry Potter. Slowly and unknowingly, Harry Potter became a big success. Later, she started using this important next step of imagination. Imagination comes only when we are happy, or only when it is when everything is going on fine. But she used imagination as a tool when she was failing. She took it as a tool to success. So this particular story, we see how she became a big top millionaire from a small zero. Next poem is Ecology. In this poem, we see written by A.K. Ramanujam. He is a professor. He himself, he has studied from India. He is working in USA as a professor for South Asian languages. More than 14-15 languages, the four skills LSWR has to be taught by him. He is an expert in languages. He knows the importance of nature, human beings, mankind, human race, everything. But still, he feels unhappy because his mother lives somewhere in India. It is very far from USA. And he visits his mother only yearly once. And whenever he visits, he finds that his mother is saying she is having migraine. She is suffering with migraine because of the champak flowers which they have in their courtyard. Ecology poem is about the love towards the nature. How we should maintain our love towards plants and animals. How they are mixed up with human beings. Here the particular character, mother of Ramanujam, says that the tree should not be cut. When Ramanujam says that the champak flowers are causing damage to you, they are making you go into trouble. Why do you want this? Let us cut the tree. But she stops him and says that we should have them as such and we should keep them because they are as old as me. And God and nature both are equal. Trees as old as me. We should not cut the tree. They are like small ones. The champa flowers, maybe my granddaughter will keep them. I should keep them safe. So such things are her words. But being a professor also, Ramanujam feels the tree is disturbing his mother. On the tree, on the top of the tree, there are few birds nest where the birds are there, and their droopings fall down every now and then, and his mother has to clean it. Why should a tree be there? If a tree is there, then only you'll have the champa flowers, then only you'll have the red day or the white day, then only the bird's nest is there, the drooping has to be clean. So from his view, the pollen grains of the champa flowers, we can't spread them. We can close the doors and windows for some time, but not continuously for 24 hours. Pollen grains spreading on the clothes which are dried outside, or else it can fall on us, on the hair somewhere, it will reach our nose and it may lead us to some sickness. So Ramanujam feels that the particular tree has to be cut down. So this is a combination of love towards nature and love towards mother. Ramanujam feels his love towards his mother is more than love towards the tree or the nature, so it has to be cut down. But he listens to his mother's words that it should not be cut down, it should be kept as such. Like if we cut it, something bad will happen to us. So he listens to his mother and he keeps it as such. Thank you.